to the Weird Show. We are live here on SMTX.TV. Welcome to, again, this fast-moving, weird journey of unexpected, strange, freakish stuff we call the Weird Show. It is September 22nd, 2010. Very interesting show we had on the program last week with our good friends from One Eye Doll. I turned into a doll head last week, if you caught the program last week with One Eye Doll, and special kudos to our good friends there at the San Marcos Paranormal Society who came in and talked us through how to properly do a ghost hunt and not look like a raving lunatic, which I eventually did look like after becoming a doll head on last week's show. That was very, very entertaining, I'll say the least. That was one of the weirdest shows we've done on the Weird Show thus far. But anyway, moving right along, we have a great guest on in studio again this week. Lately, our shows have been doing some in-studio guests here lately, so it's been pretty cool. Gary L. Wimmer is our guest tonight on the program, and Gary's going to talk to us about all things, well, Gary. But more importantly, welcome to the show, Gary. How are
you
doing?
Honored by it.
Right on. We were going to have you on a couple weeks ago. Schedule-wise, didn't kind of work out, and then we got you back on tonight. So welcome back.
Highly efficient and very appreciative.
Very cool. Very cool. Well, we are going to talk with you and have, I guess, some readings. Now, you're give us a little background on some of your work, because I understand that there's a craft to what you do. And
probably
and,
more of an art.
More of an art form.
Craft and art. It's a learned skill, but like all psychic things, talents or any talent, any art, mm-hmm. you have to develop it, practice it, use it, and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
And there's certainly some of us who are inclined to be attracted to psychic arts, and some inclined to be attracted to sports, and some both. So there's all different.
And some downright weird stuff.
Oh, impossible! I find that hard to believe in this world.
But you know, I understand you've been a psychic for. You've got a number of talents, a number of abilities, and I think we've got your website here, and I've got your psychic section of the website up now. You're a very multi-talented guy. You've got music background.
I started playing guitar way back in the 60s, before the Beatles came out. Freddie mm-hmm. King, mm-hmm. B.B. King, Beach Boys, and Beatles came out. And I thought, wow, that's interesting. And so I went to college to become an electrical engineer, and of course the 60s were happening. So that just opened up a whole can of worms, and I got interested in psychic phenomena. Of course, I became a radical and a musician. I went through all the ups and downs of the musician mm-hmm. world. I got out of college and played music and started giving psychic readings. In college, I started reading a lot about psychic phenomena because I was frustrated about religions. They never seemed to nail it. They all had disagreements so hard. I want to learn the really unifying truth.
Right.
And, it's been a passion of mine and a curiosity since as long as I can remember.
Well, I think that's something I can probably relate to, just because I grew up kind of had a family that had a lot of different a whole bunch of slew of different religions kind of were.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up as kind of as my father's religious.
Test,
if you will, or I was going to say more like a trade show or some sort, you know. But
pincushion.
You know, and so I kind of ended up experimenting in a lot of things, and, mm-hmm. and ultimately, you know, I was always very, very curious about stuff, and so that hence kind of started my whole interest in the paranormal and kind of the alternative science, if you will, and
mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
I can relate to that experience.
Oh, I figured you could.
Man. Oh yeah,
this kind of
hence we're here together tonight.
I figured you were not the guy that works down at the bank. So.
That's right. But well, I've got your website up here, and maybe we can show a screenshot of that, and I've got. This is the psychic page here about.
It's basically how I read stones, give some history into how I got into it, why
yeah.
I got into it, and so forth.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about this, because see, I'm no stranger to having my cards read
right.
or some of these other you know, alternative things I've experienced myself, but this one is one I've never had done before.
Very few people know about it. In fact, I didn't either. I started giving readings in 1972 with pro cards and different, you know, regular playing cards. In 1980, I met a lady named Alice Warhol who did a reading for me this way, and I was fascinated because it's very intuitive. And there are 16 stones, and it lays things out in according to weeks and months, so to speak. So I was fascinated by it, wanted to learn. She gave me a quick lesson, and most of it is learning it by trying it, by experience with it. Now, I have in the last 6-7 years have written a book about it. I hope to publish pretty soon because there's nothing on it. In fact, I started writing this book because I got on the internet and wanted to find out how other people did this. You know, I've been doing it since 1980, and there's nothing written on it. So I thought, encouraged me to write the book. So I hope I'll self-publish it in the next month or two, maybe sooner.
Well, let us know when you do get that, because we'll like to maybe have you back on when the book's published.
Love to. Yeah, but it's a very fascinating art and very unique.
Yeah.
And I'll just give you a real quick example of how it works. Say, and I use this, this is like a clock. It's pointed, here's 6 o'clock, here's 12 o'clock.
Okay.
So I'm reading around like this. So the camera's probably seeing a little different angle, but we're going to be reading for people on this side.
There we go.
So anyway, this is 12 o'clock, and this is 6. So, for example, if you've got the play stone and it lands here at 2 o'clock, and you've got Pluto. Pluto can be very heavy. It can cause a lot of transformation. A lot of things come to the surface. Arguments needing to get settled, that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. It calls for resolution and some pretty tough situations. So you could assume that in the second week, that would happen, something like that would happen regarding place, especially when it's leaning on the circle, which represents the environment. Whereas if it was Jupiter, which is very benevolent, brings a lot of good things, you could assume just by looking at the geometry of it, that a lot of very empowering, opportunistic, expanding things will happen regarding place. So that's just a rough idea. And when the stones land together in different configurations, they mean different things. And it's very intuitive because they'll never land the same way twice.
So, like, the intuitive part of this, is this like if I put my hands over the tarot card or ask a question, it's reflecting whatever I put, whatever energy I put out?
Sort of. The stones land in the right place. Okay. I know that because I've seen too many times.
Okay.
Where the intuition comes in is, say you've got these three stones, and say you just got this pattern, okay, what these mean. You know, that's where the intuition comes in. You know what all the planets are, but what they mean together. This might mean one thing, and this might mean something else, and this might mean something else. So the intuition comes in to interpreting, because each stone has meaning, and when you see two of them pointing to each other or touching, like this would have some sort of meaning here. If you got male energy, Mars and Jupiter, it probably means a lot of energy coming from or to or towards a male. And if this was here, it'd be affecting place, and if this was here, it'd be, say, affecting principles you got to break through. This is Saturn putting limitations. Mm-hmm. And if it was here, it'd be affecting Venus, relationships and balance. So it's really how the stones fit together. And this might be one thing, whereas if Venus was right here, they'd all be lining up and going together. So that's where the intuition comes on, the little nuances of how they point and touch.
Now, do people roll these up like throwing dice, or, I mean, how
does
this...
Yeah, but hopefully not that far.
How does this work, you know?
What people do, when I do it in person, I give the person the stones, I charge them up a little bit first, give them to them, they charge them up, and ask them to drop them in the circle. They can either drop them some at a time or all at once, and I always check the physical... what's beneath here, how hard it is, so because I kind of know how heavy the stones are and about how high to drop them. In other words, I don't want someone to drop them from this side, they'll go all over.
Right.
Or if they drop them real low, they're going to end up in a little pile like this, and it's hard to read.
Okay.
So I hope to get them to drop at a height where there's reasonable distribution.
Okay.
But however they do drop them, I read them. So sometimes some go out, sometimes you have a lot over here. No two patterns are the same. When I do them over the phone or on other radio shows or set radio shows and so forth, I charge them up and I tell the other person to say drop whenever they feel it's right, and I drop them and just read like that. When I'm reading for someone, I put 6 o'clock toward them. Right now this man's in the chair where we're going to read, so I read from this way. When I read over the phone, I turn 6 o'clock to me, so I read them like a clock here.
Okay.
And the person sits opposite me, I sit them at 6 o'clock, so I start reading at 12 and around. Like, it doesn't matter. It's just, you know.
Now, when you do a reading over the phone, Gary, is it? Do you have to know some information about that person?
I have to know nothing about them. No, all I ask them to do is say drop. And the reason I like that is because I have to depend on intuition and the stones. And it amazes some people how much information I can get out with that saying one single word, drop. But it's in the methodology. Like I showed you with just the place in the Pluto or place in Jupiter, just these little examples, how much can be implied just by knowing the meanings of the stones and where they land.
Okay.
So the nuances of it is where the intuition comes in.
So let's add, before we have, we've got our own Dave's in a studio here, and he's been... Dave, of course, has hosted some shows here with Hill Country Live in the past, and he's going to have his stones, I guess, read. Is that how we call that? Have our stones read, and then we'll do that. And then, but before we do that, I'd like to ask you about your psychic ability and how did you come to recognize this this talent?
Well, I started noticing when I was really young, but I didn't know what it was. Mm-hmm. And as I was telling you before the show, I had two very dominant older brothers. So I took a certain, I was a sensitive, you know. I was so I had a natural inclination toward sensitivity and awareness. And even someone who looks at my horoscope can tell that I would be a natural person who'd be inclined toward this. As opposed to, I don't have children, I've never been married. There's not a whole lot of influence in my astrology there. So even in my chart and in my life, I'm kind of, this is the way I'm set up. I got interested in it because in college, like I was saying before the show, I started realizing that religions just didn't answer the questions. And raised Catholic, I thought, there's a lot of holes in this theory. Yeah. You mean there's a heaven and a hell and the God going, oh, I'm sorry, folks. Oh, you got 20 points, you go to purgatory. It just seemed childish to me. And so I wanted to understand more about life and God and the universe. And that took me into metaphysics. And in 1977, I had an experience where I wrote a book about it that I'll soon publish called The Second Eternity. I went out of my body in the middle of a car accident, went through this tunnel of light, came back right in the middle of a downtown Austin and didn't get a scratch. And I saw things that were unbelievable. I just saw the truth. I saw the mind of God for a split second and came back a completely changed person. Mm-hmm. Everybody who has that kind of experience says, wow, it is beautiful out there. So I have absolutely no fear of death, first of all. The challenge is here, not out there. It's here. This is the challenge, folks.
Yeah, you know? I think that death is a lot easier than we think it is.
It's beautiful. It's mad. No God's going to take you.
But after that experience, you felt a sense of self-empowerment.
Well, I had been doing readings many years before that. But all of a sudden, I got... I start understanding the connection between things and how things in that other world, the non-physical world, they're not as clearly defined as, you know, this is a pair of glasses, this is a piece of leather, it's a table. It's like an ocean. And it's so close to us. That dimension is so close to us, but our conscious mind blocks it out so we can go about normal living. In truth, our subconscious mind picks up signs about the universe, about everything all the time.
Yeah.
And our conscious mind filters 99% off so we can live, so we can survive.
Do you, one thing that I've always thought, and I don't know, you know, you get your feedback on this, is that I think that each person has some kind of truth inherently in us.
100%.
And whether or not, I think that half the battle in life is recognizing, you know, spiritual truth.
Everybody's got some connection with their soul, their conscience, their mind. Mm-hmm. And once you have a little connection, you can broaden it. That's choice. You know, that's some self-empowerment. As I said in the Bible, ask and you shall receive. It doesn't say, don't ask and we're going to dump it on you. No, it's just ask and you shall receive.
Yeah.
Knock and the door shall be opened. It doesn't say, you don't even have to knock. So you have to pursue. If you want to learn things, you have to pursue. If you want to know the truth, you can. But you have to be willing to look past your own biases and history and what culture tells you and what religion tells you. You have to really look into the depths of your soul because no two people have the same perspective.
Yeah.
It's an infinite universe, and we're just little dots here. We each have a little different view, but we're all connected to the same only source.
What are your thoughts on the theory that that God, the theory that God is experiencing us experiencing itself?
Have
you heard of this before?
I believe that God's looking at himself in a billion different ways.
Yeah.
Not just through souls, but through every atom. You know, people ask me if I believe in God, and I say, I believe in nothing but God. Mm-hmm. You find one molecule anywhere in existence, one thought, one idea, that's separate from God, you have a non-infinite God.
Yeah.
Infinite God, by definition, is everything.
Yeah.
We're the ones who are biased. We're the ones who have limitations, not God. And we, throughout history, man's tried to take God down and impose our limitations on God. You know, well, God wants this. Well, God believes, well, God's a little bit broader than any of our biases and stronger than all of them added together and squared a million times.
Well, you know, I found that, you know, with what I do with Weird Magazine and publishing Weird Magazine, and I've hosted numerous radio shows in the past, mm-hmm. Weird Radio, and mm-hmm. And more recently here at SMTX.TV is the Weird Show. And whether it's been my craft of publishing or radio shows or what have you, it's always been this kind of... I don't know if you call it raising the consciousness or just very alternative. Yes. And that's been something that I've always done. And I don't know if it's a gift to gab or if it's just me self-seeking.
Probably both.
For myself, you know.
And other things as well.
But I found that to be a very interesting aspect in my life is I've called me the seeker. What's that, the Who song, you know?
Well, people who seek find.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people who don't seek, they don't find.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no rule that says you have to look for the truth. I mean, you can believe and do whatever you want. But you're delaying your own satisfaction, mm-hmm. relationship with the universe, relationship with other people. You know, there's so much we can know and learn and do that's just so rewarding in life beyond just worrying about our own butt.
Well, you know, having said all that, and it's good to kind of bouncing a little bit off of each other here, let's go ahead and turn to our in-studio
test subject.
What didn't want to say guinea pig, Dave.
Lab rat.
Lab rat, it'll be all right then if that's okay with you. But our good friend Dave here is in the studio with us, and we're going to have you do a stone reading here with Dave, so
okay. Let's
check it out.
Appreciate you being my subject here, man. I'll charge him up for just a second, and then I'll give him to you and let you charge him in your hands. Probably should have done this a little earlier. Just charge him. I'll show you in just a second what to do. I learned this when the lady originally mm-hmm. taught me, and I kind of keep it as a ritual. And interesting enough, I have read stones for people without having my stones. I've used bottle caps, cigarette butts, guitar strings, things on the side of the road, because it's all symbolism. And if you teach yourself to see symbolism, you're teaching yourself how to understand the universe.
Mm-hmm.
So let me show you how to drop them. Try not to drop them in one little pile, not go too high, but whatever feels good, either all at once or some at a time or whatever. Okay. Now I usually start in the center and read out to 12 o'clock. You drop Neptune first, so you're working on new dreams for the future, what you want, your new expectations. And because of both love issues and emotions and a lot of changes, it's got you thinking about that, how you've looked at things in the past and how you want to go them in the future, how you want to see expansion. So a little bit of all these things are affecting you, emotions, love, a lot of recent changes. Now, in the first couple weeks here, what you're going to experience with Saturn is the limitations you see around you that you have to break through, whether the policies or your own self-imposed limitations, they're going to help you. You're going to start seeing ways around those, expansion. You're going to see ways to make your organizational ability better, which helps you have a stronger foundation in general. And this gives you emotional satisfaction. It helps you start using this sort of almost like uncertainty you feel like you're living right now, like the world's a hurricane or something. You're trying to grab onto things. So it's helping you center. It's helping you balance and get practical ideas and so forth. Deal with your responsibilities, but also add new visions to them, where you're going to take them in the future, new plans. So you've got both responsibilities, envisions coming up in the first couple weeks. Now, this is also helping you execute things more on time, get more precision, get more ability to prioritize so you can make the right decisions. So this is also a certain amount of culling here in the process. So in the first couple weeks as you go through that, you're making use of all this energy, just both optimism and uncertainty. But as you face these obstacles, it's helping you learn the practical ways to apply that zest, that feeling, that emotion, that change, and so forth. This is going to help you, on a personal basis, heal from a lot of things that are kind of below the surface that are needing to be dealt with. And they're going to help you get your own energy to where you're very progressive thinking, and you're seeing the ways you need to go with commitments, whether it's legal issues, whether it's issues with environment, or whether it's issues with your business and so forth. So you're having to kind of let go of the things you can't affect and change rather than have them eat you up. And by doing that, you're centering your energy more and more on what you can accomplish. And that you start dealing with here in the second week. And by the third week here, you feel how a lot of this transition from both the chaos, the organization, and the transformation you're going through is going to really help you center on not only the practical sides of your goals, but what you have to do about them as far as getting the mechanics in place, decisions to be made, whether legal things, whether issues with personal commitment, with love, and all the above, because they're all kind of connected. All these things are connected right here in the center. Now, what this is going to offer you into the fourth and fifth week here is a lot of luck, because of the changes you're going through, a lot of fresh communication abilities, promotion, getting people on your side, and a lot of being able to not only feel balanced, but feel like you're an attractive force to be able to bring elements together. These people and these people don't quite agree. So you've got a lot of this blending that's coming in as a result of you getting over the processes that prevent you from seeing that blending, and as you get more organization and because of the inspiration you're feeling. So by the fourth and fifth week here, with both relationships, communication, more directed, centered activity, and a lot of luck following you because of the change you're making, you're actually going to have a lot of balance. And this is when you really start getting a lot of rewards from what's right now seems like it's confusing and uncertainty and so forth to some degree. And by the fifth and sixth week here with the luck stone, you're getting more and more return on your investment as far as applying yourself. Even though there's a lot of changes in your plan, things that are happening, whether it be economically or socially or keeping up with the times and whatever you're trying to do, you're getting a lot of luck with being able to know how to implement that on a regular basis because of the balance and because of strong communication and because you're able to clarify your points in the first couple weeks and then express them in the third and fourth to fifth week here to where you get partnerships and people helping you and people working with you. And this certainly helps with female relationships and love and balance as well. So it's both personal and professional. And by the sixth and seventh week here, a lot of the issues with place that you feel like one moment's kind of heaven and next minute's kind of emotionally unsure, you're going to get that a lot of that energy resolved to where you feel more confident and you feel more emotionally satisfied. And I'm doing this a little bit faster. I don't know how much time we got. But from the about the 8th to the 10th week here, with both the Sun Stone and the Life Stone, you're going to realize really what you've done in this 3-month period, how you've been proactive, how you've turned what seems like uncertainty and chaos into tactics, plans, into promotion, into lining your ducks up, into letting go of things that you can't heal or change, either from the past or so forth, or with partners, ex-partners, that sort of thing, such that by the 8th and the 10th week here, you're going to find yourself having come out of this very focused, and with a new, with the Life Stone and the Sun Stone are both having to do with your personal feeling on top of things. So you're going to get a lot of feeling of being on top of things from the 8th to the 12th week. You're going to get a lot of benefit of what you've, the new visions you put in place. And beyond this 3-month period, your ability to make things happen with timing is going to be a lot more magical. You won't have this debate. You'll be over a lot of these conflicts. You'll have some of the garbage that's holding you back out of the way, and you'll be able to work a lot better on knowing who to talk to, when, how, and what to promote to what degree to get things working smoother for you. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of what I'm seeing in a nutshell.
And does
what does this mean out here?
This is the timing stone. This is magic. This is how you're... See, it's pointing up, so it's it's outside the circle. And this is showing beyond this three-month period, even though you're lining up how you're getting your timing to work, beyond this three-month period, it'll be like second nature.
Mm-hmm.
You know, your intuition is going to be very good. You've got a lot of intuition here, too, with both Uranus and Neptune here. A lot of intuition, and love has brought some of that out of it, whether it's for the good or bad or the ugly. It's kind of made you dig into deeper, more subconscious, more spiritual things, and that's where you're getting a lot of your empowerment with. So it's not only with practical things, but it's with this, like I said, this inspiration you feel, even though you're going through enough change, you don't have any choice. You're going to have to feel inspiration, or it's going to make you kind of go, oh, what the hell? Yeah.
Can I ask a question here?
Sure.
I was just curious because I wanted to know, Dave, is this kind of coming across as some information that you were you open to some things before doing this, or is he kind of hitting right on, or is he completely left field with the
thing? No, there's some goals that I'm trying to achieve.
So it sounds familiar.
You were talking about in the 2 week period. I just a few months ago started a swimming program and to compete, and it's like boom, boom, boom.
Good for you.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And it's along with that, and then work related stuff, and yeah,
cool.
And relationships that it's kind of
that's a tough one right now to see you dealing with, but you're gonna come out.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Much better on this.
Right on.
Smarter, more balanced, more magical too.
Mm-hmm.
Intuition's really strong for you right now. Yeah. Let it guide you. It's
gonna I'm glad I don't have to go see a doctor. That's what I was afraid you're.
No, you got it. You got it in here, man. You know what you have to do.
You need to see a doctor really badly.
You know what you have to do, man. And you're in the first week and a half too. You're going to be doing a lot, a very constructive organization, laying plans out.
Yeah, so I've been finding myself doing that even in the last few weeks. It's just like I've got to get, you know, this.
That's why the hurricane's been building up, saying move forward. You've got enough of the plan to go start it and then figure out what you need to add to it, you know.
Yeah.
So that's kind of in general what I'm seeing. Now, if someone asks this question, I may go back to refer to other stones and so forth, because it's very flexible.
Well, this is cool, because we've got a couple of other, what did we call them?
Test subjects.
Test subjects. Vicky and Cordelia are out and back in our green room, enjoying the fine refreshments that SMTX.TV offers here at the Weird Show. And anyway, what we're going to do is take a... I'm cracking myself up on that. What we're going to do is probably just play a quick video. I want to remind the viewers, though, that over the next couple of weeks, I've got some tickets here. These are some tickets I'm going to be giving away. I have two tickets to Rob Zombie and Alice Cooper that I'm going to be giving away over the next couple of weeks through the month of Halloween. That show is, again, October 24th. So I'm going to be giving those away. And I got another pair of tickets to Black Label Society, October 29th. That's a Friday. But I'm going to give those away probably once we get into the first part of October. But I do have some tickets. And... also, there's an interesting thing out there for all you lovers, husbands, wives, lovers out there. Check out the Harvest Moon tonight. I wanted to go over a brief news story on something here, because tonight is a very, very rare,
beautiful
Harvest Moon. And I don't know how
you're the
psychic. I mean, maybe you could speak to that too. But
it's in Aries, I think.
We could probably bring this up. I pulled up an article here on Super Harvest Moon Autumn Phenomena is a really rare treat at this time of year. It's the last days of summer in the Northern Hemisphere, and the beginning of the autumn season is perfectly coincides with the full moon tonight. And it's the first time in almost 20 years that the stars have aligned for an event like this. So we fully acknowledge that the moon is not a star, but it was very often we get to use the phrase in such close context. So the moon is fuller than it's been in a long time. So the reason I say lovers, you know, get out there and hey, do that thing you do, lovers. And, you know, when the moon is ripe, if you're trying to have a baby, Lord knows I've had a few too many. Hi, darling. How you doing? Hi, kids. I know y'all are watching. My babies. I love them all. All three of them. Anyway, if you want to conceive a child, here might be the night for you to do it right here on this harvest moon here. And we wanted to point that out for the... for our viewers. And you know, hey, that's kind of funny, Gary, that you're, you know, hey, you're on the show tonight. It's Harvest Moon, man.
I noticed you coming in. It was beautiful.
Yeah, so check that out. And just wanted to remind our lovebirds out there to check that Super Harvest Moon, man. So get out there and harvest you some love up tonight if you can. And and you can harvest up some of that love tonight, guys, if you go down to Tantra. Because they got that, what's that, tribal night. Down there. So, you know, tribal night at Tantra is kind of like that scene from Matrix without Keanu Reeves, but plenty of beer. So check that out down there at Tantra. You might be able to find that Harvest Moon lover you've been looking for. Anyway, I'll quit rambling about our Harvest Moon love affair. And we're going to play a quick song, and maybe we'll do a commercial break or something too, and then we're going to rotate out our test subjects, and we'll bring out Vicky and Cordelia one at a time and have them do a reading. And just maybe, if I'm lucky enough, this show will run out of time before I get to have a reading. Just maybe. And I'm planning on working my jelly as to make that happen. Lord, he knows that. Okay. Now, in the meantime, I think we're going to play us a little Churches in Session here at the Weird Show. We're working on some an upcoming issue. Producer X, we got a cover of Weird Magazine that's coming up next month in October. It's my 6th anniversary issue of Weird Magazine, and that's coming up, our birthday. Yeah, pat on the back there. But we're trying to get an interview with Reverend Horton Heath. So as we go out and preach the gospel of Weird to the masses next month in October, there's our prototype cover. We're covering the Freak Show Festival, which is featuring... the mighty Reverend Horton Heat. I spoke today with the band Creep Show, which will be on October 6th, and then the Coffin Cats, who were on our Spring Break cover earlier this year, will be doing another brief interview with them. The Coffin Cats will be here on the Weird Show on October 13th, and then I may have Ark Attack on later in the month. And so a bunch of really weird kind of Halloween stuff we're working on here at the Weird Show in the next coming weeks. But in honor of the Reverend Horton Heat, hopefully we'll have him on next week or in the weeks to come, we're going to play a quick Reverend Horton Heat clip as we rotate out our fine, lovely test subjects and waiting in the, no doubt, luxurious green room here at San Marcos Television. We'll be right back. This is the Weird Show.
Thank you, man.
Oh, you bet. Well, I hear a train coming. It's rolling around the bend. And I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. Sun's going to force the fumes on. And time keeps dragging on. The train keeps rolling. Oh, I'm sick of the train. When I was doing it, my mama told me something. Always be a good boy, but can I play with guns when I shot a man in Reno just to watch him run? I hear the whistle blow, I hit my head. And I hear the whistle blow. We'll be right back.
probably drinking coffee, smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be good. But I think I'm coming over, and that's what torture.
There's our brief clip there with the good old Reverend Horton Heat. And maybe we'll look forward to checking him out here in the coming weeks, October 23rd. But in the meantime, we'll get back to the Reverend. I want to do a couple of quick announcements for some of our sponsors here on The Weird Show tonight. We'll go ahead and thank those guys now. That's our friends over there at Fault Line Liquor. It's all back to school drink. That's been going on here in September. That's the Nutty Professors. It's the students are back. Check out Fault Line Liquor and the Nutty Professor drink over there. Go see my good friend Art over there at Fault Line Liquor at 1904 Ranch Road 12 right here in San Marcos, Texas. And our good friends over at De Blasio's Pizza reminding you to don't get busted ordering corporate chain pizzas. Shop local with our good friends at De Blasio's. And you can order those pizzas online right now, deblasios.com. In fact, I had some last night on the way home, De Blasio's Pizza. Also, right down the street from them, down the hallway, is Gray Horse Saloon. Every Wednesday night, man, you go to the Gray Horse Saloon, and it's Big Lebowski Wednesdays at the Gray Horse. So they got the $2.50 Caucasians and the Colorado Bulldogs over there. And then, of course, Gray Horse offers the best in live local music in San Marcos. And this is all right. All three of those guys are right there in the same shop there. Then our good friends there at Italian Garden reminding you that dinner is served daily there at Italian Garden. And you can also bring your girlfriend. Hey, tonight's a good night to go over there with us. That Harvest Moon. You can bring that bottle of Chianti over there and do that thing you do with your girlfriend there, the fine folks at Italian Garden, and just do that fun stuff, you know, at home, not in the parking lot of Italian Garden. But anyway, moving back to the show, thank you there for our sponsors there. And, you know, that was the Who track. I don't know if you guys can hear that. That was the Who in the background, the Seeker. Uh-huh. And, yeah, they call me the Seeker. Been searching high and low, man. All right, welcome back to the program. If we can, Producer X, if you could bring up that cover again. I wanted to emphasize that the Reverend Horton Heat is on October 23rd. We're trying to get him on the show. I'm hoping he's watching tonight just to make sure I'm a real person. Anyway, we have that cover, and it's the Freak Show Festival that's coming up on October 23rd. And last week, we were able to meet with the folks over there at Three Way Events, and they're working with Weird Magazine on our 6th anniversary issue here for the Freak Show Festival. So we've got Reverend Horton Heat, the Creep Show, the Coffin Cats, and then there's several of these original Freak Show Fests, the original Freak Show people. There's several different tours that are going on, and we're doing interviews with them also in the magazine. So we wanted to just mention that in the coming weeks, Weird Magazine, the Freak Show Fest, and our good friend Reverend Horton Heat hopefully be on the program next month. And anyway, our next test subject in the studio has seen Reverend Horton Heat live. Our friend Vicky, how are you doing? Welcome to the program here tonight. Thanks for coming aboard.
Thank you for having me, Russell.
Right on. That you shared with us during the break that you'd seen Reverend Horton Heat a while back.
Oh, yeah. Back in the late 80s, I was a huge Jane's Addiction fan.
Uh-huh.
Playing Sunken Gardens in San Antonio. And the Reverend Horton Heat opened for them, and I had never seen them before. And it was amazing rockabilly, and just it was so fast and so crazy. And they had like a little freak show there as well, Carnival, before the James Addiction show. So he's always been into that kind of thing. So it was just,
Yeah, this is a real treat to have him on, and we're trying to get an interview set up with him. So we'll probably have either a video Skype interview or a phone interview with Reverend Horton Heat. And I was telling you during the break, and Gary, you might be able to comment on some of these experiences. In the early 90s, I had a doozy of a... let's just say a hallucinogenic experimental phase of my life in the early 90s, and I can't even remember if I saw Reverend Horton Heat, but if I did, it was either at the Continental Club around 91, or it was either at Liberty Lunch, and Liberty Lunch, it was no longer after about 95, and I used to go and hang out at Liberty Lunch. Mark used to run that place over there, and no, but I think I've seen him before at Continental Club in the early 90s. Nothing I can fully really remember.
Well, you should remember because it's amazing.
I think if I'd have seen him, I'd have really remembered it, you know, and not just some flashback that I might have been having on Guadalupe. But anyways, welcome to the show, Vicky, and I thought we would have you be a test subject as Gary is making sure I'm politically correct on that, and we wanted to of course have you come in and be a test subject and see what you think of having some having your
lithomancy reading.
Yeah.
Lithomancy.
Yes.
Never had that done before, but I'm very excited.
I have never had that done either, and I may not ever.
Come on, Will. You know you are.
If I can help it, I may not ever have them done. No, I'm just teasing. We'll probably do this pretty soon here as well. Real quick, Producer X has reminded me here that we are streaming, you know, folks on the iPhone and the iPad, anything with an I in front of it, we're streaming live on. So, just want to remind you guys that at home, you guys watch the show. There's me watching me, watching me, watching me, watching me.
Hey,
watching
we go me, to infinity. Me.
Infinity there. But, no, very cool feature there, the streaming application that we stream out three different ways, low bit and high bit HD stream, which many of you are watching. And then folks really don't know. Sometimes we forget to plug that very cool feature. That we stream on the iPad and the iPhones. So wanted to mention that. And then, Producer X has reminded me that our good buddies at Coolabyte make all that happen. So just want to shout out to our good streaming media partners on that. And back to Vicky and...
Let me show you how to do this.
This magical experience here.
Try to not drop them in one little pile, not go too high, about here, about this height, either all at once or some at a time. Whatever feels right, that they're going to land in the right spot. And I'm just doing this in case they decide to jump off the table.
All right.
Okay. Okay, now here's the way I'm going to read. I'm going to start here at the center and read out to here. You actually have a lot of luck going on you for right now. You have a lot of luck. You have a lot of expansion. You have a lot of communication that's working very good for you. Part of this is things you've learned through recent things with love and place, and it's kind of giving you this sort of charge. And so your communication efforts are very effective. You're going to find them helping you make good starts on things you're negotiating right now. You're working. You're trying to promote. Now it's going to, you'll start planting seeds here. You already have planted some. You're going to start planting some more in the next week or two as far as instigating things, moving things forward. And your communication skills are going to help out a lot. But you're going to have to kind of reiterate. You're going to have to kind of go back over things again, explain them in more detail. Because this has a lot of techniques, details, and logic that you're going to have to lay out for people. So everybody will understand and be on the same page, something like that, you know. So this goes on for the first couple weeks. And the more you do this communication, the better you get in the first couple weeks. You're starting to get your system real effective, you know.
Okay.
And by the fourth and fifth week here, I'm going a little fast because I don't know how much time we got. By the fourth and fifth week here, you're going to find out how much that affects you on your business, on your new projects, on the way you feel about all sorts of things that you're committed to. Whether it be business, whether it be your own spiritual growth and so forth. And that's going to cause you to have a lot of like emotional fulfillment in your life, satisfaction. Right now it's kind of lining all the ducks up and doing some of the organization work and contacting people and getting things going. But you're going to have a break here in about the fourth and fifth to the sixth week where the things you've put in play are going to start working of their own momentum. So you're doing the right thing. You've got good timing. You've got good communication skills, and you've worked for these because you've been through a lot of things in the past that you had to really get really deep in the gut in order to survive, make sense of it, and so forth. So you're applying that, and that's very, very empowering for you. And during the fourth to the sixth week here, as it brings you new visions about your life, about what you want in the future, about what you want in your environment, your own home, your own place. So there's changes being made there that are going to make you feel more powerful. They're going to make you feel like more at home, more in tune spiritually and so forth, and emotionally. And by the sixth week, you've really opened up a cycle of luck for yourself. You really have. You got a lot of good things happening for you here, and you did work on them. They didn't just fall on you. It's the time and place, and you've been lining things up in the recent past in spite of or because of what you've been through. So this is sort of, I'm starting where you're getting the reward cycle of this. So it looks good for you. And from the sixth to the eighth week on, with this lucky cycle of you being proactive as well, it's not just luck that's going to fall, it's you making it happen. That's not only making you feel more balanced about relationships, about business, about all sorts of things. It's also, by the ninth week, going to help you as far as when you have to draw the line on things. You have to start implementing rules, policies, and working within structures in order to make things work effectively. So, and in this process, there's going to be a lot of negotiation, give and take. You know, you're going to have to do some compromising here. But you're in an empowered position because you can, it's like persuasive. You know that what you're talking about. You've lined your ducks up. And part of that's the communication skill. So you've got the confidence to be able to make a compromise that works and it's fair, but still doesn't, you don't surrender power. It helps you set up policies that work for you. And from the 10th, 9th to the 12th week here, there's new things about love that you're going to find about your place. You're going to feel yourself more empowered. You're going to feel yourself more just happy, fulfilled, and so forth. There are both things from the past that you kind of are dealing with a little bit coming into your environment, kind of sorting out. Mm-hmm. And you'll be kind of going through those still at the end of this three-month period to varying degrees. Whether it's a breakup, an emotional thing, family things, things like that. But you don't have to digest it all at once. You know, it's kind of, you're taking off chunks of it as your empowerment increases. And in the long run, what this is helping you is a couple things especially. It's helping you develop a better sense of awareness, intuitiveness, spontaneity, creativity, breaking through rules, being open and expansive. You see what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Using all sorts of creativity. It gives you a lot of strength to deal with men, too, in the way that, where you don't get this sort of backlash and the sort of pressure that you kind of feel from time to time because of past relationships and so forth. So you're getting a lot of strength from men, and you're able to, you know, use the resources of men but not have to surrender your power. So it's very, that's where your creativity in dealing with men comes from. And this is going to help you long term to where you, like the grudges that you may have, you're going to recognize they've been assets in the long run. Do you understand?
Absolutely.
Because they're going to help you with your spontaneity, your creativity, your empowerment. You've got a lot of good things happening for you, girl.
Sweet.
Keep on the plan. Does this make sense to you?
It does. I do property management, and I'm trying to expand and get more properties. And actually, I've been dealing with a couple of people, and today, exactly, and today another one fell in my lap just from doing my job and doing it the way I'm supposed to because of the knowledge I have of my 15 years of experience in it and all. And so, and I do know what I'm talking about.
I know. I
all these
feel
owners don't know what's going on in real estate. And as I tell them, they're like, ooh, then they tell a friend, and then I get another call. And so my business is growing because I know, you know, I do.
Well, you've
the right
had to
thing.
Line your ducks up. You've
oh,
had
yeah,
to do
for
homework.
Years, yeah. for like yeah. 3 years, and it's all starting to pay off.
It is. It is. So you're on the right page. You're on the
Sweet.
Right thing. Don't be too frustrated if you have to, like renegotiate or go, they didn't get the point, you know, that
yeah,
sort of thing.
It takes
a lot of communication and
reiteration
and knowing kind of when to push and when to let them decide when to push again. So there's a lot of balancing act there, but all the energy is working for you in very powerful communication.
That
you.
Is beautiful. Thank okay. you. So
well, you
much.
Did it. I'm just you know, reflecting.
So, so we can say just like Dave experienced before, you kind of felt that there was something going on there that it was touching on
sure.
personally. So
oh yeah, and I like very, the men comment.
Cause, yeah, I mean that's
they need to get
I straighten them up.
You straighten them up,
you know, vampire slayer trying to get it. In
that's
there.
Why you have to certain keep a distance
exactly.
with men. That's right.
Uh-huh.
Let me
yeah.
sort out what I want before you.
Yeah, before you jump in here and tell me what's up.
There you go, girl.
Yeah, well, I love it.
Well, very cool, very cool. And what we'll do is I'm going to play a spot for one of the Weird Magazine advertisers, and then we'll switch out and we'll get Cordelia in here.
Sweet.
Cool?
All right.
Okay, cool. Well, this one here is our good friends. This is a quick announcement from our friends down there at Museum of the Weird.
I found the perfect place to take the whole family.
Museum of the Weird. Come see Austin's strangest attraction featuring monsters, mummies, freaks of nature, and the Fiji Mermaid.
What is it?
Explore educational exhibits, learn about the Texas Bigfoot and Shrunken Heads.
And even taught you how to make one!
Don't try that at home.
Explore the paranormal, the unexplained, and the just plain freaky at the Museum of the Weird. 412 East 6th Street in downtown Austin. Museumoftheweird.com.
All right, there's our good friends. That's my buddy Steve Boosty down at Museum of the Weird right there on 6th Street. And of course, that place is really busy during Halloween because Austin is notorious for it's kind of the Austin being like the 6th Street area on Halloween. It's kind of like Bourbon Street and Fat Tuesday, you know. So anyway, Steve always gets a ton of people going there. So if you've ever been to the Museum of the Weird, go check out my friend Steve. And all the fine guys over there at Museum of the Weird. Anyway, we'll turn back to our new test subject. Cordelia, welcome to the Weird Show. How are you?
Good, how are you?
You kind of really fell into this deal tonight, huh?
Yeah,
didn't know you were
going to
be on TV tonight at all, but thank you for being open-minded enough to come down here and hang out with us weirdos.
Thanks for having me.
We're not weirdos, Gary.
Nah.
We're not weirdos at all. We're,
nah.
No, but yeah, just I guess shuffle the deck there.
Okay. When you drop them, don't drop them in one little pile. Don't go too high. About this height, either all at once or some at a time, and they'll always land in the right spot. Male problems. Right? There's some things with males that you're getting worked out. Women are always so complicated because y'all are just more complicated.
They're just complicated.
I'm never surprised to see male energy having a lot of effect on them. So don't worry about love in the long term. It's going to happen. Don't worry about right now. What you're focusing on is what's going to move you forward with your own personal life, with your own sense of who you are, who you want to be, what you've been through. You're going through a lot of adjustments to get clarity so you kind of can look back with a certain... maybe not regret, but a little more like understanding and forgiveness and, okay, I can move on, because that's going to bring you clarity. And that's going to bring you this sense of expansion that you're feeling in your life and will soon feel more and more. So in the next couple weeks, as you feel this intuition in you and you feel new dreams and you feel new things starting, and even though they're not real clear exactly what transformation you're going to, they're helping you with a couple issues. They're helping you with your own confidence. They're helping you with solve situations with some man that you're having to work on here. And you're going to have to do a lot of, a lot of stuff's coming to the surface. Some of it's going to be easy to deal with. Some of it's going to be hard to deal with. Some of it you can ignore, and some of it's going to hit hard. So that's why I want you to have confidence through this process. Because what it's giving you the ability to do is be able to not hold a grudge, to move forward, to be positive, to be thinking, to not be hurt by someone else's opinion or lack of vision or lack of understanding or sensitivity, these sorts of things. So that's giving you strength. So even though you're going through this process, consider what you're going to gain through it. And that's going to be a lot of luck. And that's also going to be further empowerment for you. So this is a part of your life here with men and male relationships and so forth, where you're really having to get kind of to the nitty gritty. And that's not a bad thing, because that opens up to you more here in the sixth and seventh week what you really want, where your expansion is, what your goals are. And in this process, there's going to be a lot of opportunities for you, both emotionally, personally, and you're also, by the eighth and ninth week here, whether it's job or life or both, you're finding yourself having to do this stuff, but wanting to experiment with this. And having to do all these obligations and work and daily routines and whatever, but wanting to expand your vision at the same time. So in a way, you're getting the best of both worlds, all three worlds. You're starting fresh. You're starting with a lot of opportunity and optimism and growth. You're getting over these things with the male energy in order to feel more powerful. You're learning a lot about that and getting a lot of luck from that, which is going to help you expand and so forth. But in that expansion, both personally, physically, emotionally, and so forth, you're going to find yourself drawing new rules, drawing new limits, having to do more organization, having to throw out what isn't working and bring in a lot of newness, a lot of freshness, a lot of creativity, and a lot of your intuition. Your intuition here by both these two stones is coming to the surface, so don't be afraid of it. Learn it, get familiar with it, because it's going to help you, especially in terms of decision-making, in emotions, in relationships, and so forth, because no, you can't always tell what's behind door two. But your intuition can give you a lot more guide in that area. So you're learning a lot about intuition. You're learning a lot of new principles. Part of it with this healing, part of it with the visualizing you're going through, part of it with the empowerment, and partly because you're applying luck here in a proactive way that's helping you break through these constraints. And that's going to give you a lot of satisfaction in relationships, in balance, in your home, and being able to really see by the end of this three-month period not only what you're long-term plans are, but what you need to get there to do them. And these are the stones that are outside you. That's why I was saying, don't worry about love right now, because you've got it out there in your future, but you've got a lot of personal things that you want to grow and expand on too, and you don't want to be sidetracked or misled or duped like you have been. You know, of course, everyone has been duped to some degree by guys, but beyond this three-month period, you've got the life stone, you've got magic stone, you've got communication mercury, and you've got commitments. So this is leading you toward better commitments long term, better businesses, getting your skill sets up to where you have better communication skills, to where you're a better salesman, and you do that with more confidence with yourself, more clarity. And this is all helping you, like the man that did the reading a while ago, with the timing stone out here, you're getting all your ducks lined up so you can make decisions better, feel more balanced, feel more confident, not having to look at the regrets before you even make a decision, but look at the good things that can happen. So expect a miracle. You know, don't expect necessarily to have to go through a bunch of crap again, because crap always comes with this. Maybe not. You know, see what I'm saying? You're learning to see new visions and new empowerment, and that's going to bring you the good love in the future. It's going to bring you a very satisfying life. It's going to bring you an expert sense of being able to do things, start things, initiate things, especially with business, communication skills, and relationships. And with that, you're covering a lot of bases.
Does this make sense to you?
Yeah, it really does.
That's kind of what I'm seeing in general. If, I don't know what our time it is, but if you have any questions.
No, we're okay. I mean, we got we probably got another maybe 10 minutes or so here.
And, oh, okay.
And no, how did you feel? Is that anywhere?
Oh, yeah. I just graduated college, so I have like all these different opportunities I've been kind of looking into, applying for different jobs and stuff. Mm-hmm. So kind of went along with it pretty well. And there, I mean, there's a couple little love interests here and there, but nothing serious. I'm not really worrying about that right now at the time. So
yeah, that's what I was feeling over here. One thing I feel is, it is a tough market now.
Yeah.
You know, don't let that get you down, because you're also learning other skill sets, and even if you have to take some sort of temporary thing that's not necessarily in line with your goal, you can develop your artistic and business pursuits over here and do this, and you're still getting an education through, because I kind of feel sorry for folks your age now stepping this job market, you know. We screwed up the economy a lot, people my age, you know, unfortunately.
Oh, I think I'm partially blamed, so.
Well, probably less than us. But I did want to, I could see this sense of you being challenged here by not being, the golden door's not opening as fast as you'd like. I mean, but you've got so much power. And you have unique talents, both artistic, presentational, that sort of thing, inspirational. You've got good motives, a good education, and good foundation. So you've got a lot of things working for you. Just don't let the doors that look like they're closing bother you. Just go on to the next. Take it as an education. Learn from it, just like you have learned from having other dreams broken. Learn from it. Don't, you know, don't get down by it. Just go, okay, well, it's empowered me further. That makes sense to you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Back to you, Mr. Okay. Superhost.
That's cool. So it's kind of all gel in there too, right?
Oh, yeah.
That's cool. That's cool. Well, I'm kind of interested to see what mine say, I guess, or see what, you know. Well, I'm gonna,
if you want to
blow,
do it,
I'm gonna blow on them. And oh, but you know, gosh, we're out of time tonight. Man, what do you know? I'm so sorry. We just didn't have enough time tonight. I'm so sorry, y'all. No, I'm kidding, guys. Well, let's really do it. We'll really do mine. Let's go ahead and do it. Let's figure out how we're gonna do this. I'm gonna play a quick clip, and then I'll go ahead and pick them up and blow on them. And
I'll turn them this way, and you drop them from this side.
Okay,
so
okay.
Toward you.
Okay, so here what we'll do is, yeah, it's just not fair to the viewers.
It's
I know
not.
Everybody at home really wants to know how I'm doing here.
We want to expose Mr. Weird.
We want to expose the weird guy and all my dark side and secrets and everything. So let's go ahead and do it. I want to remind everybody, if they'll turn here to our Super Harvest Moon again tonight. Be sure to take that special someone to Italian Garden before they close in the next 15 minutes. Or just get a bottle of Chianti or something and do something romantic tonight. Because if you've been wanting to make a baby, this may just be your night. Super Harvest Moon Phenomena. Rare treat. Okay, moving back to the transitional phase here, I'm going to play a quick video of Creepshow. Creepshow will be on the program in 2 weeks on October 6th. A very cool band, and also performing at the Freak Show Festival on the 23rd of October. So check it out.
There's a dark garden where you lay your head tonight. Through the darkened hours, were you thinking of me? State of sleep is what you'd rather be.
cry. Don't you go now. Don't you go now.
There, very cool stuff from the band The Creep Show. Again, they are performing October 23rd at the Freak Show Festival. And those guys will be video Skyping in on The Weird Show live from Chicago on October 6th. So that's in 2 weeks from tonight. So good bunch of weird stuff coming up in October for The Weird Show here, Gary. So we're looking forward to... this kind of time of year for us is kind of like the rest of people's, all them white people at home's Christmas. Anyway, while during the song, I grabbed the stones. Is that right?
That's correct.
And I blew on them, and I shook them up real good, and I dropped them all, and they all fell in to the lasso there, and so here we go. We're doing the Weird Show. Russell's
Well, I will testify. Russell did drop him so he could get back in the booth.
That's right.
And I turned the leather around, so this is 6 o'clock facing you because I always okay. have the little knot facing the person. And what I'm seeing here, Russell, right now, you've got Jupiter right in the center, so you've got a lot of expansion in general going on for you. Cool. With both business things and so forth that you've already been working on, mm-hmm. and with how you're going to organize and communicate those in the future, in the pretty near future. So this is showing you a lot of exuberance, mm-hmm. a lot of getting things lined up, good communication, good structuring, and probably restructuring some things too. Mm-hmm. You're going to do a fair amount of like negotiation, getting everything worked right. But you're not only getting a lot of fortune out of this on a business level happening and a lot of planning strategy, it's giving you emotional relief. It's giving you a feeling of, like with women, ex-wives, whatever, that you feel a lot of power, mm-hmm. that you feel a lot of almost like gratitude and graciousness, mm-hmm. which is not necessarily maybe what you're thinking about, but it comes about because of you get a good high about other things expanding, and it kind of gives you this feeling of like... being very in control of your emotions and your luck and so forth.
Cool.
So that's helping you out in the first couple weeks, not only with, it's sort of a side result of you using good communication skills, mm-hmm. Applying fresh ideas and principles, feeling expansion going on, and doing what Saturn does is make things more efficient for yourself.
Okay.
Just make decisions as far as, you know, I'm not going to waste my energy here, I'm going to put it here where it really... has a profound effect. So as you're doing that next couple of weeks, it's going to give you an emotional high. It's going to give you a good feeling about women and relationships and your kid and so forth, mm-hmm. your kids. Mm-hmm. And that's turning into a very good lucky cycle for you as far as turning some things about love that have kind of been in the surface. It's turning them around and putting a whole fresh light on them.
Okay.
And that's happening from the 4th to the 6th week here. But because the stones are close, it's not necessarily happening in that week. It's a transition. And by the 4th to the 6th week here, you're going to see a lot of this change within yourself that's going to give you, with the magic stone and Neptune, which is going to give you a lot of strength, a lot of direction for the future, a lot of new ways of... not only seeing yourself, but seeing what your job entails, what you want to expand on your show, in your mm-hmm. magazine, other ideas you're bringing in mm-hmm. That are leading to possibly other businesses, other ventures, and so forth. So you're starting out with things being organized. You're getting them a lot more organized than they even have. You're drawing a lot of lines, setting up principles, time, schedule. Helping you emotionally, helping you a lot with feelings you have about love, and bringing a lot of the issues about love to the surface so you can clear them out. So you've got the emotional part of you and the practical part of you working together. And this sets off a really good pattern for you from the 6th to the 8th and 9th week here as far as projects, as far as business, as far as you feeling very empowered, mm-hmm. as far as you feeling like you're moving ahead of the curve,
okay.
Being very futuristic thinking, planning and so forth. You get support. You get people who are supporting your projects, your mm-hmm. ideas. And by the 8th and 9th week, you've kind of liberated yourself from a lot of what feels like right now it's stress on you doing everything at once.
Yeah,
you know? You're getting a free-form pattern to where
both delegation helps, delegating other people, finding yourself just on a real good high because of what you see in the future. And that makes things work for you because it gets people to support you and move quickly. They know what your idea is. They go, cool. I like that. So you're getting a lot of that's freeing you up so you can feel like by the 9th and 10th and 11th week here, you can really feel like, wow, I've got a lot of things organized. I've conquered a lot of frustrating issues with love and so forth. Got new visions, got support, got my ducks lined up. Not only do you feel a sense of freedom and futurism and creativity, but by the end of this three-month period, you've got a system of balance here that's just so much better than it is right now.
Now, Gary, does it say anywhere in there about a vacation? Anywhere? Vacation?
If you wanted to, Lisa, I get the feeling you're doing so much organizing, you won't let yourself take one right now.
Well, you know, that's very, very cool because, you know, I've gotten involved in this this freak show festival, and I've got a vendor booth over there. And so I'm kind of coordinating. I'm very busy with, like I said, for Weird Magazine, gearing up into the Halloween month, which is, again, 5-6 weeks down the road from now.
You have a lot of power.
Yeah, there. That's a lot of stuff going on for us this time of year. And like I said, for a lot of people, Christmas, for especially the white viewers at home, it's like Christmas for y'all. But for me, Halloween is like Christmas for us weirdos, you know. So
your weirdness is going to manifest in a very good way, and you're going to touch other people with it.
Well, yeah. we try to touch people in the right spot, in the good spots, of course. No place bad. But, yeah, man, this is actually, I feel pretty empowered by all this, man.
You're moving into it. You're moving into empowerment.
And all my rocks went in the same lasso.
Right.
So that was good.
Yeah.
Nothing was outside.
No, what I notice is this, because they're all close and there's a lot of stones, that there's just a lot of things pulling you a lot of different directions.
Okay.
But see, the main thing you've got in the next week and a half is getting real organized as far as time, schedule, communication.
Yeah, it's because
so things are said once or twice,
I got a print on October 1st, and so there's a lot of work I got to do right now, and that's probably what that's
deadline you
that.
Feel coming up here. Yeah, because Saturn, that stone, is just saying, here's the line. It's got to be finished.
Deadline.
And
deadline. So wow. Far. See, I may. Man, can you train anybody to do what?
Well,
what
I've
is
written
you
a
do?
Book about this. It explains basically how I read it. Explains what the stones mean, and gives a lot of examples. Now, the examples I use in the book aren't based on real people. They're just based on me moving stones around and saying, this could mean this or this or this.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of showing you how to look at patterns and see something in them. And when you do them for a person or a situation, then is when you really start learning the intuition.
Well, I see here, you know, you've got, you were interested in the works of Madame Blavatsky and Edgar Casey. I mean, that was one of the things I started reading. I think I read The Sleeping Prophet by Jess Stern when I was, you know, 19, 20 years old, and that really kind of got me rooted in some of this interest.
When I first started reading Edgar Casey, I went,
phenomenal
this
stuff.
Makes sense, man. Finally, it all ties together.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he was a very gifted psychic and really empowered a lot of
people.
Yes,
and what's his organization? The Association for Research and Enlightenment.
Correct.
And I bet you if I ask, I could get somebody from Virginia to probably video Skype in on The Weird Show.
That'd be
and
nice.
Just have them talk about Edgar Casey and the R Foundation. So
phenomenal battery information
yeah.
in there.
Yeah, I saw that here. You're a fan of his. And Edgar Casey, again, the sleeping prophet. Well, you are by no means close to a prophet. This is pretty good. You're four for four here. In the studio, producer X interested. Shout out! No, he's giving me the run. Too bad we're out of time. The watch there.
We'll stretch another 20.
We can stretch it for us, can't we? Now, no, he's yawning back there. But really, a great show tonight. I want to thank Gary. Really appreciate you being
thank
coming
you very
down
much,
here. Glad
Russell.
To have you on there. A very different show for us. Last week, I became a doll head and had my face painted all up and stuff, and that was interesting. And but this was a very enlightening, empowering show tonight, and I really got a good vibe about you. Why don't you get that book published and come back on the show, and we'll promote your book on here. In the meantime, how can folks get in touch with Gary Wimmer and get in touch with you. I see you've got your website. Fire that off for our viewers.
The best way is to go to GaryWimmer.com. That's GaryWimmer.com. Go to GaryWimmer.com. That's my homepage. Or go to GaryWimmer.com/psychic. You'll end up with the psychic page, which explains this page here, which explains how I give readings and so forth. If you forget all that, you can Google reading stones, because I come up on the first page of Google, because I've written a book, Lithomancy, the Psychic Art of Reading Stones. So you can find me by Googling Lithomancy, Reading Stones, Gary Wimmer. Go to GaryWimmer.com. I'm not hard to find if you want to go that route. Reading Stones will bring up my website. Well, at least the Lithomancy website.
I think it's super, super cool. I was a little apprehensive at first, and I was just joking with the viewers. You know, I was kind of just having some fun with that. But ultimately, I knew I'd probably just, you know, go ahead and have a reading.
Well, thank you for participating, Randy.
Well, I was, what was it, what were we called? Test subject number four tonight. So I was the fourth test subject. Very cool stuff, man. Our guest tonight, Gary Wimmer, thank you very much for being a part of the show. All right, well, next week we have kind of an open window. I may be talking on the show with one of the guys from, it's one of the guys from the upcoming Freak Show. We may be having one of the carnival teams that are going to be on there on the program, and we're beginning to get a call in from maybe the guys from the Coffin Cats. They're going to be talking with us. And I want to give away some tickets for the upcoming Rob Zombie Alice Cooper show in October. We'll look for us to be giving away some tickets during the month of October, maybe even some tickets to this upcoming Freak Show Festival that Weird Magazine is going to be a part of. Dave, Vicky, and Cordelia, and yours truly, I want to thank everybody for coming in and participating. And I want to, again, thank our guest, Gary Wimmer, tonight on The Weird Show. Stay tuned next week. Same time, same channel. Thanks to Coolabyte and Producer X here at SMTX.TV. I'm Russell Dowden. This is The Weird Show. We'll see you next week.
History ain't changed. God's a bad